This video is sponsored by Magellan TV. At the height of the Vietnam War, the U.S. military was deeply interested in implementing a new attack chopper that would pack a punch and pummel enemy ground forces in the dense jungles of Vietnam. The military also aimed to use it as a support vehicle to escort Hueys carrying soldiers and Marines to battle. The Sikorsky Company was already a renowned name in helicopter manufacturing, with the S-61, S-64, and S-65 models in production. But over that prior decade, the company had lost competitions for the Army Utility Helicopter, the UH-1, the Army Large Utility Helicopter, the CH-47 Chinook, and several other mission roles. Their newest prototype, however, caught the attention of the Army. It was the S-67, a unique helicopter with tremendous capabilities for any kind of combat situation, thanks to its slender fuselage and its astonishing amount of firepower. It was the ideal chopper for winning the war in Vietnam, but sadly, it arrived too late to change the tide of the fight. Only one Sikorsky S-67 was ever completed. It was America's first Blackhawk. The Blackhawk is the U.S. Army's primary frontline support and air assault aircraft, and has been deployed on some of America's most secret and dangerous military missions. The Blackhawk continues to be refined today, even incorporating rumored stealth technology. Now you can learn more about other military advances that have shaped modern combat in the Magellan TV documentary Top 10 Warfare Aircraft. Magellan TV is a new type of documentary streaming membership created by filmmakers that brings over 3,000 documentaries to all of your devices without interruption. Visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies or click the link in the description below to get a free one-month trial. Watch the Magellan TV series Top 10 Warfare to see rare archival footage that ranks the most important battles, weapons, aircraft, inventions, and secrets of war. Support Dark Skies and check out Magellan TV with your one-month free trial today. Even more new programs are being added on a weekly basis. Be sure to click on the link in the description below or visit try.magellantv.com/darkskies. A new type of cavalry. In 1964, months before the war in Vietnam began with full American involvement, the U.S. Army put out a request for proposals, an RFP, for its new Advanced Aerial Fire Support System, or AAFSS program. Lockheed Corporation and Sikorsky Aircraft were declared the winners of the submission. Sikorsky presented the S-66. This helicopter had a conventional central rotor system, a two-man cockpit, stub wings, and a unique tail rotor on the back. The Sikorsky tail rotor could rotate 90 degrees to act as a pusher prop as the helicopter's speed increased. The overall design was light and straightforward for going above and beyond the call and came in under budget. The CL-840 Cheyenne was Lockheed's design. This helicopter had a two-man cockpit with a rigid main rotor system, standard stub wings, a tail rotor, and a fixed pusher propeller located at the back of the fuselage. In November 1965, the U.S. Army felt that the S-66 program was a risky option to take, which turned the odds in favor of Lockheed's Cheyenne, declaring it the winner of the AAFSS competition. Nonetheless, several years later, in May 1969, the U.S. canceled the production contract with Lockheed due to ongoing mechanical problems with their prototype. During these years, Sikorsky engineers followed the Cheyenne helicopter development closely, conducting initial studies on an improved version of a high-speed helicopter gunship known as the S-67 Blackhawk. This aircraft was an amalgamation of the Cheyenne, the Sikorsky S-61F, and the canceled S-66 compound helicopter. In the last days of 1969, the United Aircraft Corporation pursued the development of the new helicopter without any military funding. The S-67 Blackhawk program was finally approved in January 1970. John McKenna, Sikorsky's executive vice president, was in charge of developing the prototype. Attack and support missions. For the war in Vietnam, the U.S. Army needed a helicopter with a heavily armed and armored attack system capable of defeating Soviet armor at range while promoting excellent speeds and crew protection. The official Sikorsky fact sheet for the Blackhawk established its purposes, quote, "The S-67 was developed primarily as a high-speed helicopter for direct aerial support, including anti-tank use, but has the potential for other missions, such as high-speed rescue, high-speed troop transport, cargo or weapons-carrying observation and surveillance, and anti-submarine warfare." For attack missions, the Blackhawk had deadly firepower capabilities. It could carry up to 7,000 pounds of arms and ammunition for the turret-mounted 7.62 gun and the 20 and 30 millimeter cannon. It could carry 40 millimeter grenade launchers, wing-mounted rockets, and tow missile pods for explosive arms delivery. For search and rescue operations, the Blackhawk could fly 600 miles at high speed using auxiliary fuel tanks mounted on the wing. For observation and surveillance missions carrying new electronic equipment, the Blackhawk could detect and record the enemy activity and movement. Although not part of the original configuration, later improvements of the cabin could transport up to 6 armed soldiers at 165 miles per hour over distances up to 220 miles. The new development and design specs. The budget for the Blackhawk was set at $3 million per unit, and the team had just 9 months to complete construction. Fabrication of one S-67 prototype began in February 1970. It was completed just 7 months later, and about $100,000 under budget. On August 20, 1970, the first flight took place at the company's Stratford, Connecticut facility. The fact sheet further explained the inspiration behind the helicopter, quote, "The S-67 is a combination of proven components and new design concepts. The result is a new helicopter weapon system at greatly reduced cost and technical risk, high performance, ease of maintenance, and early availability." One of the main features of the S-67 was its slender fuselage with a two-man cockpit, which was only 3 feet 10 inches wide. This design was created with the purpose of increasing the speed potential of the helicopter. Behind the cockpit was a compartment that could be used for additional equipment or to transport personnel. Another additional benefit of the fuselage was that it increased survivability by presenting a smaller target to enemy gunners. The pilot and gunner were seated in tandem beneath a single canopy. Both men used standard cyclic and collective controls for flying. The helicopter used high-speed swept-back blade tips that were flown to speeds of Mach 0.9 without any adverse effects on its performance. A sizable vertical fin provided directional stability that was new for helicopters of its time. Another innovation of the Blackhawk was that the fin began to take over the torque-compensating tail rotor when speeds reached 46 miles per hour. If the tail rotor became inoperable because of any circumstance, the Blackhawk would still be able to safely fly home and land. The wingspan on the helicopter was 27 feet, and it had 2 hardpoints for weapons, fuel tanks, and other weaponry. The wings were detachable, as they were not an integral part of the helicopter in troop transport and external load missions. However, the wings had some innovative functions for a helicopter, such as the air brakes. Each wing had 3. The Blackhawk was the first aircraft to implement them. With the air brakes deployed, the helicopter slowed twice as fast as without the air brakes. The air brakes could be deployed during combat to offer a never-before-seen maneuverability for helicopters, drastically increasing target accuracy and acquisition while in movement. In just 3 seconds, they could be open or closed, increasing deceleration by 100% and 40% when at a steeper dive angle. The S-67 was equipped with 2 General Electric T-58 GE5 1500 horsepower turbine engines, which were the same used in the Sikorsky S-61. The 2 front double main wheels retracted into sponsons on the side of the fuselage. A non-retractable tail wheel was located in the back of the fuselage. Maneuvering tests. The aircraft flew from 1970 to 1974. Pilots loved it. It was very maneuverable and responsive. Loops, rolls, and split S maneuvers could be made without any problems. Test pilot Cannon, with co-pilot Brian Graham, established a new speed record, averaging 216.8 miles per hour over a 1.86 mile course in December 1970. Following the S-67 test program, Sikorsky was awarded an Army contract to further evaluate the aircraft's speed brakes, stabilator, and aircraft maneuverability capacities. Most pilots agreed that the Blackhawk had unmatched performance compared to any other helo of the 60s and 70s. One pilot said, quote, "The S-67 is very maneuverable. I experienced up to 3 Gs and could easily bank and turn, split S, and generally rack it around. The visibility is excellent from both cockpits." The evaluations conducted in July 1972 at Edwards Air Force Base, California, were an astounding success. The Army appreciated the technical innovations of the aircraft. The shortcomings were a minor issue. Only 39 were spotted during testing. Some of the corrections included stabilization issues when doing maneuvers and emergency measures such as external emergency access handles, placement of caution panels, and the lack of steps and handholds for cockpit ingress and egress. The Blackhawk's legacy. In 1972, the Army evaluated the S-67 and the Bell 309 King Cobra as alternatives for the new attack chopper they had in mind. Sikorsky proposed a production configuration of the Blackhawk. Nonetheless, the U.S. Army decided to initiate a new gunship program, the Armed Attack Helicopter, or AAH. This program would give life to the legendary AH-64 Apache. The company continued to validate the performance of new additions to the Blackhawk. These included updated navigation systems, heads-up displays, night vision, a low-light TV, and a new turret system. Exterior updates included rudders on the ventral and dorsal fins to increase yaw control, and the compartment space behind the pilot's seat to allow the aircraft to carry 6 passengers. In the last effort to increase firepower, hardpoints were added to the wings for carrying missiles, and a hook beneath the fuselage to allow the aircraft to carry a 700-pound external load. Blackhawk down. In the summer of 1974, the S-67 prototype was shipped to England, arriving in August at RAF Woodbridge in East Anglia. It was set to fly at the Farnborough Air Show. Unfortunately, during a press preview flight, a fatal incident occurred. The S-67 hit the ground during a right-hand low-level roll maneuver. The co-pilot, Stu Craig, perished in the crash, and the pilot, Kurt Cannon, also passed away from his injuries 9 days later. The prototype was completely destroyed. Sikorsky decided to terminate the program following the accident. As industry tide shifted again later in 1976, Sikorsky was named the winner of the Army's Utility Tactical Transport Aircraft System, or UTAS, for its medium-lift utility helicopter, the YUH-60A. This new and powerful helicopter would be named the Blackhawk.